Hey, I got a couple comments on asking how I would I use a bait and how I rig up for sturgeon. There's lots of different ways that guys like to do, and the way I found is most effective for me is it's pretty simple. I'm running a 10 foot. This is my bank rod. I have a 10 foot Daiwa M cast. It's rated 15 to 30 pound. That's for mono, so if you're using braid, you could obviously put a heavier poundage on there. I'm running 25 pound. I'm not really fishing for big oversized fish. This is for my keeper harvesting. I'm running a Penn Jigmaster. It holds a lot of line. The first thing you want to do is take your you don't have to use a swivel, but I like to. You can use a snap swivel too. But I'm just using a barrel swivel. It doesn't make much of a difference for me. And first thing I'm gonna do is I have my weight here. So this just happens to be a 2 ouncer, and I have some 12 pound with two loops on each end lassoed onto there. And I'll take it and take my barrel swivel and lasso it through like that. So it just on there, and if I get hung up, I can just pop that off. So I don't worry about losing any other gear. So the first thing you do is take that and just run it down your line here, like that. The second thing you put it on is a bead, big enough that won't slide through the hole of your swivel. It's got a little green one here. You're gonna go ahead and run that through. Like that. Then you take your second swivel and just take that with your knot of choice. I like to run a clinch knot, so it's a little bit modified. Run it through once. Run it through twice. But on the second one, I don't cinch it tight. I leave it looped. And I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then run it through both of my loops that I have there. Keep that. Grab a hold of your tag end here and cinch down on your line. Make sure that's nice and cinched down there. That. Then I take your nine cutters, and you want to leave a little bit of tag. Sturgeon aren't very picky. I probably leave about quarter of an inch, centimeter or so, about that. And then next part is you can use braided line, but what most guys use is called Dacron. It's kind of like braid, but it has this kind of flat diameter on it, and it's really thick. And the sturgeon, they're so focused on being down there feeding, and they won't care at all. They don't really go by sight that much. They mostly just go by smell and feel. So then, you take your Dacron here, and when you use braid, you usually don't want to use it to tie a clinch knot. You want to tie like a pulmar or something. But this is so big round, it won't cut into itself, so you don't need to worry about that. So I use the same knot that I just used on my mono. Sometimes I don't even run it through twice, but can totally up to you, whatever you're most comfortable with. I'm just gonna leave it through once, and I'll have quite a big enough swivel, and take it, and you know. Just do, I do about 8 wraps when I'm using braid or Dacron. That, take it, and I'll actually go through my bottom hole that I made twice. Just hold on to that. Get a little wet to help it slide. Make sure that's nice and lined up straight. Go ahead and give it a little pull. Sometimes it's hard to get cinched here. There it goes. Like that. You have that tied on. And then I have this tag end. And what I like to do with this is I just fold a little loop. Run the other part of my leader. Come through. It'll make almost a knot. But I leave that knot open. And I run my tag end through that. Pitch in my teeth. And pulse like that. And then, take my the other end of it here and run it through my hook. And then just tie up my clinch knot. A lot of guys tie egg loops too. I haven't really had the need to because I'm not looping anything on. So I just tie a clinch knot or pulmar or whatever your favorite knot is. And then take it and fold another loop, go over your hook, get that tag in your teeth, and pull like that, and it'll just hug it down like that. And I just like that, have the tag in there in case something goes wrong. That's your rig. You're probably kind of thinking that it's kind of a long leader for a bottom feeding fish, since they're right down there. But this leader is about to become a lot shorter because the bait you put on, I have two different kinds here. I have pickled squid, which I normally use, and either herring or smelt, both of them work. I'm just gonna demonstrate here with some herring. Pick whichever one out of here you want. I usually run them whole. You don't have to, depending on how big they are. This is kind of a big one. Here. Yeah, I'm just gonna use a smaller one. Here's your pickled herring. What you want to do is take it. If I can get my hook out of here. Okay. So then take this. And you're going to run it. Sturgeon always like take whole bait head first. I'm gonna go through the tail here. And just go ahead and pull my hook out. Then I'm gonna take out and I'm gonna go about and just so then the eye on my hook is even with that thing's mouth. Just like that. Take it and go ahead and just put it through again. Slide it through, and I'm just gonna keep sewing this thing down until I get down to the head or close to there. Keep going. You might need a little more line. Go again. And then, once you get close, so then this is just gonna be dangling there. I like to take it, make sure it's nice and tight. Just take it, and I'm just gonna run it right through the head here. Like that. And then that's gonna sit just like that, and your hook will just be hanging out of the head there. It's just like that. And in Oregon, Washington, you have to use barbless hooks. I think it's pretty good lock because they have such soft mouths. So then, and that bait's just gonna be laying there on the bottom. And they're always gonna suck that up head first, just like that. And that's
looks like that's about a perfect bait to use there. If you can, try to get that hook as straight as you can. It's not that big of a deal. A lot of guys like to run half hitches, but I found that takes up a lot more leader than sewing it down, and I haven't had any difference in my catch rates. And some guys will cut off the tail if they're fishing in really heavy current to keep from your leader getting all tangled up. What I've noticed is when you're getting a bite from a sturgeon, one of the first things it's going to do is it's going to come over here. Here, I'm going to break this rod in half to show you this real quick. Okay. So, you'll be sitting there, you'll be watching your rod, and it'll just kind of get a little bump, 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 like that. A lot of guys will pick it up and set the hook as soon as they see that bite. What I like to do is I'll watch it. And I've had fish come by and just hit it like that, and I'll wait for close to 45 minutes to leave and come back. They'll just sit there and just start swimming around it. And it'll start kind of doing this little boom, boom, and it'll start doing it kind of consistently. Then I just gently pick up the rod without putting any tension on that line, and I'm going to hold it, and I'm going to wait. And that rod tip will start doing these kind of rubber bandy things like that. And that's when they start really sucking it up. And just give it all you got and just drive that hook through those lips. But I hardly ever miss fish when I do that. It's worked great for me, and hopefully this has helped you. Another thing I like about this rod is it has a really soft tip. All your big surf rods have really stiff tips, and when you're fishing for sturgeon, you want a nice soft tip. And you want kind of a fast tip too, but you want it nice and soft. Because when you use a big heavy tip, they'll come by and they'll feel that rod tip and they'll just drop it. So you want that nice. You want something good backbone to get good hook sets, but that's what you want to be looking for. But that's what I like to do. Hopefully that helps you, and let me know how you do.